What's up guys, King Louis here with another Mordor video. This time around, I wanna try to answer an often asked question among Mordor newcomers. The question is, what is the best build when starting out with the game? Starting out in Mordor can be quite intimidating. There are no newbie servers like there were in Chivalry, and even though there are still plenty of newish players on frontline and invasion servers, you will probably die hundreds of times before you can achieve a somewhat consistent kill-to-death ratio of around 1. The following build aims to give newcomers an easier and less frustrating start in Mordor. It is not only a build, but a whole playstyle that I think should work very well for beginners. The build I have in mind is a support build with a spear. Support build means that you help teammates by applying pressure on the enemy from a relatively safe distance. The spear has the best range in the game and has great stab damage. Stabs are very good in team modes because it is less likely that you hit your own teammates with them. How this playstyle works in practice is pretty straightforward. Position yourself behind a teammate and follow him into an engagement. Now, the important part is that you always want him to be the one that gets initiated by the enemy. You never ever want to be in the front row. With your teammate tanking the aggression, you can now stab the enemy from a safe distance without the immediate threat of getting hit and dying. If the guy you're supporting dies, or you just can't follow him anymore without exposing your position, you simply reposition yourself behind different teammates. The positional awareness in combination with the range advantage makes it so you don't have to parry a whole lot of attacks throughout the game. Avoid situations where you are outnumbered at all cost, since getting outnumbered means almost certain death for a beginner. Instead, look for skirmishes where your team outnumbers the enemy. Don't be afraid to turn around and sprint to teammates instead of just slowly backpedaling away while staring at the enemy. Another thing to keep in mind is to not feed the enemy easy parries, from which they can get free riposts off. Try to time your attacks with the attacks of your allies, so the enemy has to either double parry or cancel his own windup to parry your attack. Obviously, opponents that are not directly looking at you are the easiest targets, but it is certainly not worth it to sacrifice your position for one or two free hits. This support playstyle can be very powerful and is sometimes even used in competitive play, most of the time with light armor. However, since this is a beginner guide, I recommend going a little heavier with the armor. My suggestion is 2-2-2 with a pavis and a bandage. Mobility is very important for this playstyle, since you have to reposition yourself behind different allies constantly. The pavis comes in handy against all the projectiles in a frontline or invasion game, and the bandage is always a no-brainer that keeps you in constant fighting shape for only 1 point. This leaves 3 points left for perks. I like to take friendly and tenacious, but this is up to your preference. In case you really can't get used to the spear, there is a variation of this build with the halberd in alt mode, which plays out very similar. The halberd alt grip is 15 cm shorter than the spear and has slower stab windups. As a trade-off, you can also use strikes and the weapon is a few points cheaper, which might get you one additional perk. If you start feeling confident with this playstyle, you could try to experiment with a lighter build if you feel like you want to trade some protection for more movement speed. Something like 2-1-1 or 2-1-2 works well, but staying with 2-2-2 is perfectly fine too. If you find yourself dying a lot with this build on the other hand, you are not avoiding direct engagements enough, and you might want to try to be more aware of your positioning in general. Anyway guys, that's it for this beginner loadout guide. I hope you have fun with this build. Please leave a like and subscribe if you like this video and want to see more Mordor content in the future. As always, thank you all for watching and see you soon.